night that Jesus. The communion is being served with the song, Jesus Christ, I think upon your sacrifice, you became nothing old unto death. Hold it in your hand, give His Son for you and for me. So let's be thankful this morning. Let's our hearts be filled with gratitude for what He has done for you and for me. May God bless you as you partake this morning. And once again, I look upon the cross where you lie. Children, we thank you for our families. We remember those who are sick amongst us, Lord. We pray that you will bring in healing to all my heart. In Jesus' precious name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Let's take part of it.
There's a miracles conference that's being held at Village Hall. So instead of having our Bible study at our place, we're joining the mission about it at home after service. prayer slips and everything are as usual. They're there to hand out if you have any prayer requests that you'd like someone to pray for you for. And then please do put it in the offering basket as an offering bag as they come around. So the 20th and 30th June, that's a Saturday, we could all be here from 10 till 4 p.m. We can all just work from the room. Lunch will be provided for those who come to work, not just come along. the 28th of June, we're having a celebration for Grandma Marie's birthday. So we could come along and celebrate her life with her. Yeah, Grandma, why don't you stand so everyone knows who you are? Present for that, so you can play a schedule or whatever. Try and make that happen, because as far as voting and things go, as well, we need a majority of the church to be present and things. So please do come along for that. The 27th of June, that's a Saturday as well, we're having the fasting and prayer church from 9 till 4. I realise that I'm saying a lot of dates, so what I will do is print out a calendar of these things for you guys too, so you know when it's coming up. September 26th, as you both, as you all know, that me and Daniel got our agreement, also send us all the blessings as well. So yeah, 26th, it's going to be at 7 p.m. at 6 p.m. There will be invitations sent around. We'll let you know about that, but just keep that date.
Offering is being taken. We sing this song, Jesus, what a beautiful name. Son of God, Son of God. Father, the giving of your people in your presence. Your people, Father, have needs to be met, Lord, even as they give in your sight this morning. I thank you once again, Father, for their families and their children. Continue to meet their needs, Father, and let them experience your goodness in their life, because you are a good God. And we thank you in advance for your faithfulness. In Jesus' precious name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Alan obviously had a sad situation this week, and his stepdaughter, who was actually suffering with cancer, just in her 40s, went to be with the Lord. And eternity is no longer than the life that we live here on this earth. How many of you realize that? It's too long. We can't take chances. We need to be prepared. And we need to give our heart to the Lord. I am glad, and I hope that most of you trust the Lord, and you're trusting the Lord, and I hope all of you are doing that, is that you will be successful. You know, in John chapter 16, last verse in John, and Jesus says these words. If you want to turn to John chapter 16. Are you there? God's promises and his faithfulness. In this portion in John chapter 16, verse 31 and 31 onwards, I'm going to read. You believe at last, Jesus answered, but a time is coming and has come when you will be scattered, each to his own home. You will leave me all alone. You may have peace. You cannot have peace without God. Only in Jesus will you have peace. And then Jesus goes on to say, even though you have my peace, in this world you will have troubles. In this world you will have troubles, but take perfect. We are all longing for a time of perfectness, of peace. Governments and world leaders are trying to fight and pursue peace with each other. In fact, peace doesn't come by us trying. But Jesus is saying, in me you will have peace, because Jesus knows where peace really is. The Bible says he is the Prince of Peace. And many are going to be deceived, thinking probably this is what it is. But the truth is in the scriptures. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. The truth is what is going to set you free from the situation that you may be facing. Are you there with me? 1 Corinthians chapter 10. This portion that we're going to read, you'll read from verse 1 to verse 13. And we'll read it all day. They all ate the same spiritual food.
And drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank from the spiritual rock that accompanied them. That rock was Christ.
Nevertheless, God was not pleased with most of them. Their bodies were scattered over the desert.
Indeed, and in one day 23,000 of them died.
We should not test the Lord, as some of them did, and were killed by snakes.
And do not grumble, as some of them did, and were killed by the destroying angel.
These things happen.
Not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear.
But
when
you
are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can stand up under it.
May God bless the reading of his word.
Amen.
This portion is a portion which gives us the wisdom who's ignorant. A person we call is ignorant is the one who does not have understanding. And Paul starts with this. He says, I don't want you to be ignorant. Concerning what? Concerning the forefathers, the people of Israel. What was it that they did? He said they were under the cloud, and crossing through the Red Sea was like baptism. The whole lot went to the Red Sea. He says they ate the same spiritual food and drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank from the spiritual rock that accompanied them, and that rock was Christ. See, all these multi- God wasn't pleased with them. See, when we read this portion, it is given to us as a warning. So verse 11 says, these things happened to them as examples and were written down as warnings on evil things. They set their hearts on evil things. What type of evil did they do? It says they sat down to eat and drink and got up to indulge in pagan revelry. In fact, they began to do the same practices that they saw. See, one thing we ought to remember is when we believe and become Christians, and we were discussing this on the Thursday, we are not set free in one way as long as we are to be able to overcome sin. God gives me and you the power to overcome sin. But temptations will still come. What is the purpose of temptations? What is the purpose of trials? That's a different thing altogether. But your victory is guaranteed in that trouble. And that's the beauty of it. We are not spared of trouble, but we are given this assurance that we will come out victorious. So you and I need to... Serena Williams has won her 20th Grand Slam. She's almost the second world rated. There's another person who's actually been 22 Grand Slams. Serena was winning the first match very easily. The second happened as the sure outcome.
And the advertisement that comes up on the TV for sponsoring this was Bet 365. Bet and say, who's going to win? If you want to bet as a Christian where you're going to be, you can bet and say, I'm going to come out victorious.
Yeah.
I'm not recommending bet. But yet, most of the Christians are worried. We are worried because we are thinking, I do not know. Let me tell you this one thing. That's not the truth. There may be some truth to it, but that's not the absolute truth. As Christians, you and I can expect, there is a reason why God wants you to do it. He doesn't want you to be at the same level of your faith. Why? God wants you to grow. God wants you to grow. So you need to be growing. How many of you have children whom you do not want them to grow? We all want. Why? Because we want to see them grow. Now the babies don't like everything that they want to eat, that they are given to eat. What they tend to spit it out. They tend to spit it out. Why? Because they do not understand it. That's the same with us. When God wants to bring in some correction and he acts unto the children of Israel. His ways, when he says he made known his ways, he made known to Moses who he is. His acts are the display of his power unto the children of Israel. So what did the children of Israel see? They only saw God's power being displayed. But they didn't. His character is he's trustworthy. He's truthful to his word. He will keep his word. He's God who is loving. His love will never, ever. When they come home, they know that whatever is being given to them is not filled with poison. When your children come and eat food, do they smell and see whether this is good or not? They know my mom is giving it, it's got to be good. They just gobble it up. When they sleep at night, they're not worried somebody's going to come and steal their bag and go away. They leave it there. The one who gave us ears, does not he hear? The one who gave us mouth, will he not speak? He does speak. So he is giving us the confidence that we need to do. So when we go through these trials and through these tribulations that we may be going through, which is connected with God's promises and his faithfulness that he's going to bring us through, when you go through these situations, God is bringing you to become a more better person, building you into a person who is more spiritually mature. So when we begin to become spiritually more and more mature, God ignored once again the same word, brothers, about the hardship we suffered in the province of Asia. We were under great pressure, far beyond our ability to endure, so that we despaired even of life. Paul is writing, I don't want you to be ability to endure. Think about it. Great pressure, far beyond our ability to endure, so that we despaired even of life. In other words, there was this thorn in my flesh, and I prayed to God, take this flesh, this thorn away from you, from me. And God did not answer his prayer, but said this one thing. He says, my grace will be sufficient for you, and my strength will be made perfect in your weak moments. You know, some of you are praying, Lord, take this trouble away from me. Set me free from this. And God says, no, my grace is sufficient for you. My strength will be made perfect if God is looking for it. Don't give up. That's why in Ephesians 6, he says, putting on the whole armor to stand. It's to stand. The armor is there to protect you from the onslaught of the enemy. But all you have to do is not necessarily fight, but to put on and to stand your ground. Circumstances they may be going through. When somebody is going through a difficult time, you may say, oh, that person has actually done something really wrong. Stop judging people. God has a way with everyone. And he's working out his purposes through our mistakes. Even as within Paul, remained the same way. He had the same zeal. He had the same fire. But this time, it was for Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
See, God will use everything in your life, good or bad, for his glory.
Amen.
Good or bad, for his glory.
Amen.
Because he's a God who can change things when you give it to him. Amen. You're broken. Today, I'm in a situation where, you know, it seems to me, where am I, Lord? He's going to guide me. I just need to keep. Second thing is, don't tell your troubles to wrong people. Don't tell your troubles to wrong people. But look for people who will share your burden. You go to identify them. Our burden is with us. That's what the body of Christ is. You know, as believers, we can be people who can come alongside our brothers and sisters and come alongside to lift them up and help them at the time of need. You and I have needs. I'm having my own burden. I'm sharing it with you. When you pray for me, my burden is lifted up. His burden high. You see, whatever goes through my life, the first thing I do is to come and share it with my wife. Whatever is happening in my wife's life, she will come and share it with me because immediately the burden is out. There are times I do not have answers. We'll be driving down and Sunita will tell her problems. I don't have answers to it. All I do is just listen. This came, they could not speak a word. The amount of grief was so much because Job was one of the rich men. He was the richest man. He had 7 children. He prayed for them. He was the most godly man at that time there. But yet when the situation happened, he lost all his children. You do not know in what way God is working in that way. We need to pray and be gracious and be merciful and say, Lord, help my brother, help my sister in their time of need. So the second thing is, don't tell your troubles to wrong people. There are times your burden may be so much. You are not able to share it with somebody. You can go into your room, close up the room, and cry out to Jesus and say, Lord, I am coming to your throne of grace. I know I will find rest in your presence because there is fullness of joy at your right hand. You can come to it. You can pour out your hearts. I'm not saying, you know, sometimes. Are you there? Romans chapter 8. 26. Romans 8, 26. Yes. He says, in the same way the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for. And words that cannot express. God is going to be there in your scripture. He's going to give you the words. The Spirit of God is going to give you the words. And I can tell you, the Spirit of God is only speaking the mind of God. The Spirit of God is speaking the mind of God. And your temptation will provide a way out so that you can stand up. God is going to make a way for you that doesn't seem to be a way for you. May God bless you. Whatever your situation today, whatever you may be going through, just trust God. He is faithful. He is faithful to His word. He is going to. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you. We just want to praise you that you are a master. Your ways are higher than our ways. Your thoughts are higher. Even as high are the heavens above the earth, so high are your thoughts and your ways. Lord, I just thank you for your people. They are coming to you to be stronger. Lord, even though they may be going through a dry path, you are going to bring them, Father, to streams where they can be quenched, their thirst can be quenched, that they will feel satisfied, that you will enable them to grow in their spiritual walk with you, trusting you to bring them through every situation. I thank you once again for this congregation. People not to lack any good thing. Protect them as they're going up and coming. Bless their homes. Bless their families. We pray especially for the unsaved members, Lord. We pray especially for Alan, Lord, that you'll comfort her family there. Even as he shared, Lord, there are many members in his family who do not know the Lord yet. I pray, Lord, that you will touch them and speak. Have you been blessed this morning?
Yes.
I want to share a joke before we go.